mucho, for into work done and power. That module is divided into a few topics. You get work done on a straight line, you get work done on a slope, you get work done by top, and then you draw the force distance graphs, which are the work done graphs. Today we're going to look at work done by torque. So work done by torque focuses on work done when you have a force that causes a rotation. What is torque? Torque is a turning force which acts at a distance from the point of rotation. So, or you can simply say torque is a twisting force. So it's similar to the concept of a moment. When a force is applied and it makes a rotation, it generates torque. How do you calculate torque? We calculate torque using the formula. Torque is force times radius, and that formula is not on the formula sheet, so just make sure that you remember it. Torque is force times radius, where force is newtons and radius is in meters. So if the radius is given in millimeters or centimeters, you must first convert it to meters before you can do your calculations. Okay, so why is it force times radius? Let me just show you. If you have a nut and you're going to use a spanner to take out that nut, you will apply a force. You will apply a force, and that force will have to move in that circular direction to sort of form a circle. Now, if you measure from this point to that point, it will give you a diameter. But if you measure from that point to the point to the midpoint, which is the center of rotation, it's gonna give you a radius. Now, as I said, a torque is similar to a moment, because a moment is force multiplied by the distance from the working line of the force to the point of rotation. So here, the torque will be force multiplied by the radius, because the radius is the distance from the working line of the force to the center of rotation. Just remember, your force must be newtons and your radius must be meters. Therefore, your torque comes in newton meters. So the SI units for torque are newton meters. Okay. Then these are the two equations that you use to calculate work done when a force makes a rotation, or work done by torque. Now, I'm going to show you how these equations came about. You don't have to remember that, but when you do, it helps you so that you can identify which equation to use. So you always have to choose between these two equations when it comes to work done by torque. Okay, now this equation, one came when the force makes an arc, and the other equation we get it when the force makes a full rotation. Now let me start with this one when the force makes an arc. Say you have a nut and you want to use a spanner to take it out. What you will do, you will apply a force. Now let me say this force just makes an arc, because you just wanna, maybe you just wanna make it tight or a little bit loose, you don't wanna take it out. So you turn up to a certain angle. So this is the angle, you turn up to a certain angle. So to calculate work done, we always use the basic concept where we say work done is force times by the distance. But in this case now, the force, the distance that you have will be the length of this arc. You see this arc is going to be the arc length. How do we calculate the length of the arc? We take the angle that it makes and we multiply it by the radius, which is that the radius is that distance from this point to that point. We multiply the angle by the radius. Now let me just rearrange it in such a way that you have the force next to the radius, and then you have the angle. We see that force times radius is equivalent to torque. You see, torque is force times radius. And then you are left with the angle there. Therefore, work done is torque multiplied by the radius. So that is the first equation. Only thing you must remember if you must use this equation is that your angle must always be in radians. Now, an angle can be measured in degrees or in radians. The same way length can be measured in meters.
meters to kilometers, temperature can be measured in degrees Celsius or Kelvins, and N can be measured in degrees or in radians. So you must change your angle always to radians, okay? And how do you change your angle to radians? You take whatever angle is given, you multiply it by pi, you divide it by 180 degrees. So you take that angle that's given in degrees, multiply it by pi, you divide it by 180, then it becomes radians. Let me make an example. If they give you 40 degrees, you will say 40 times pi divided by 180. So the pi, the degree will cancel out with the degree, and then your answer will come in radians. Okay, so this is the formula you use if your force makes an arc, does not make a full rotation. You use that formula. And the easiest way to identify, they will give you an angle. Just make sure that when the angle is given in degrees Celsius, you first change it to radians. Okay. And then the next one is when a force makes a full rotation. When a force makes a full rotation, your work done, let me sketch it up also. So that's your spanner, and then it goes all the way. It's a full rotation. So your work done is again force times by distance, but your distance is now the circumference, because it goes right around, is the circumference of the your work done, your leg, your distance is equivalent to the full circumference of that, to the full circumference of that circle. Okay. So you have to know now how to calculate the circumference. To calculate the circumference, we use pi multiplied by d. Okay. So I'm just going to change it and use 2 times radius instead of the diameter, because the diameter is made up of the 2 like this. Okay. And then I'm again going to rearrange it just so I have radius next to force. Then I have 2 pi. So when these 2 get together, they give us tau. So tau times 2 times pi. So this will be your work done when it makes 1 revolution. If it makes a number of revolution, you just multiply the whole equation with n. Then it becomes 2 pi n t. So we just rearrange it. 2 pi n, this is the number of revolutions that it makes, times by t. And what you must remember with this equation is that your n must always be in revs per second. Your n must always be in revs per second. So if they give it in revs per minute, you change it to revs per second, because your work done must come in joules. For you to get joules, you must have used basic SI units, which is for time, you must have used seconds, not minutes. So if they give you, for instance, 30 revs per minute, what do? You say 30 revs, you ask yourself how many seconds is 1 minute? 60 seconds. So you will end up saying 30 divided by 60, and it's going to be in revs per second. In revs per second. And that is how these equations came about. So you either use this equation or that equation all the time. Thank you.